So is Taco Pocket a thing? Yeah, they're like together, kinda. With a mixed spoon. Holy shit! 40 months, dude. That's a true bro. I'm gonna tweet that, dude. Holy Wither McSpoon. God bless, dude. Holy shit. This is a true bro. 40 months in a row. I can't even believe it. That's wild. Speaking of wild, get over here, motherfucker. All right, let me actually cast.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Donation.
Why not, lol?
Yo, another 20. Thank you, man. I honestly, like, God bless. You don't understand how much that helps me. Fuck, I can't get that ant now. Stupid fucking ant. Thank you, though. I do appreciate it. Okay, so let's get to the analyzing. Okay, so. Serenos, Poseidon Ban, Susano, Thoth. I respect it. Sylvanas first pick for the red team, but in return, they give up Kabrakan. I don't know how I feel about that. Kabrakan's pretty... I think I value Kabrakan more than I do Sylvanas, honestly. Kabrakan's actually like cancer. Like, I fucking hate Kabrakan. I'll be real. Keesh, the guy. Kunzenvo, Kabrakan, that's already massive front line. All right, Zeus. It's Zeus for Vash. Okay. No? Yeah? Oh, yeah, it's Zeus for Vash. Okay, so... Now, the biggest thing is going to be protect Vash, because Vash is like a Zeus main. Like, it's not that he's a Zeus main, but like, that's like his bread and butter, right? So, Vash is going to need protection during the team fights. Realistically, it depends on the initiation and dive out of the blue team, or else Vash is just going to clean house. We'll see. Yeah, I can't believe 40 months, dude. Like, that's... Wither McSpoon is actually a true bro. Like, that's how you do it right there. I can't even believe it, dude. Just spill the beans about Taco and Maddie. I think they already announced. They're pretty much... It seems like they're just pretty much together. Like, I don't know. I don't know what they released information-wise, but, like, they're just together. Like, it's pretty obvious that, you know, like... They're fucking or some shit. I don't fucking know, dude. I don't blame Taco. I'd fuck Maddie, too. Maddie's gorgeous as fuck. I'll be honest with you. All right. I respect the Wukong pick. I don't know why, like, for sub games, Wukong is just fucking really good. Like, I don't know. Everyone gets Draco'd by Wukong, but that's actually crazy dive for the Zeus. So, and also, Wukong can get out of, like, Kabrakan's ult. So, like, I think overall that's a good pick. It depends on where the Kabrakan goes. If the Kabrakan's jungle, then you're not going to worry too much. But Kabrakan solo against Wukong, I think it's, like, I don't know if that's an even matchup. It seems like it would be okay. Like, I don't think Wukong's too worried. Scotty, all right, this team comp is already just fucking cancer. Like, Scotty's honestly, like, AIDS as fuck. I'm not going to lie. Scotty is legitimately AIDS. By the way, guys, this is either for 200 gems or the MVP at least gets 200 gems or a skin code. I have a couple skin codes to give away. So hopefully, I'll probably do skin code for this game. I'll just give out a skin code to the winner. Maddie is an actor. He plays like he cares, but he doesn't. He does not care about his community. No comment, bro. I'm not gonna dirty him. I'm a peaceful guy, all right? I like to remain neutral. I don't know why Vash plays Arena on his own. That's actually disgusting. Let's see what the bans are. I respect the Thor ban, by the way, because that is actually crazy dive potential on the Zeus and the Scotty, because they're both immobile carries, right? So anything would kind of dive, like Thor, would just Draco their shit. Like realistically, they can't deal with that depending on their support. If the support, like, for example, if the red team picked Geb, they'd... Oh, I really hope the blue team would ban something like Geb, any kind of peel, because that's all the blue team needs at this point. Once they get self-peel, their team fight should be unstoppable. There should be no way you lose the team fight. Scotty wins every single 1v1 against Hunters. Zeus's team fight is fucking crazy. And Kabrakan. Like, he's just going to wall people and slap the shit out of them. So, like, it's really, I'm scared shitless for the blue team. Like, hopefully this Izanami does wonders or something. But I wouldn't do the Izanami versus Scotty matchup. I just wouldn't do it. Like, I don't. I'm sure it's fine. It's just that Izanami is like a hyper carry and she needs farm, whereas Scotty's just kind of good to go after trans. And the Humbats pick on top of that, so much CC and control. Really, you're gonna have jungle pressure. This guy obviously knows what he's doing. Like, I don't fucking know, dude. This is gonna be rough. It's gonna be something. Yo, what's up, Ghost? Why do the teams randomly switch? It's a bug with the client, bro. I don't know. Ghost, I hope you've been good, bro. I haven't talked to you in a bit, so I miss you, bro. I love you. Yeah, what was I saying? Okay, the Scylla safe pick. I think Scylla's fine. It depends on how good you are with Scylla. Scylla's very skill dependent, in my opinion. So I don't know. But like I said, immobile carries. She has three really easy targets to ult. So, and not to mention, she's super safe. Like, you shouldn't really die in a team fight depending on how they initiate. So, like, for example, if it's Zeus, you could just ult him. Scotty, CC'd, ult. Kabrakan literally slams the ground in place, so that's fine. The Bastet, I don't know how I feel about that. We'll see. We'll see. It's like, eh. I don't know how bad. I mean, like I said, in mobile carries, it might work, but it all depends on this Guardian pick. Unless that's Kabrakan support. It really depends on what Zek picks here. I'm curious. Could be solo something. I don't know. So back. I think that's okay. Not as much peel as I thought it would be, but I think Sobek is a fine pick here. Why does it switch? I don't know. Hi-Rez really doesn't know how to make a game. That's really it. Like, I just they haven't gotten it down yet. They're just fucking ridiculous. All right, red team is gonna severely have to outplay. Oh, Gray Apples is probably going Xing Ten support. Oh my god. Yo, Virtuous, thanks for the 14 months. Welcome back to the church. God bless. I do appreciate it. Thank you, bro. Damn, 14 months. That's wild. By the way, so yeah, Gray Apples is going Xing Ten support. Kabrakan solo, Zeus mid, Scotty ADC, Humbats. Blue team's comp is like as cancer as you can get. Like, that is it. Like, that is the ultimate. It is great team fighting. Great 1v1. Fucking even Xing Ten can carry this game. Like, the red team is going to have to severely outplay the blue team. And it really depends on how the jungler does here. It really depends on how they initiate team fights. Like, everything has to go right for the red team. Everything. They need an early game lead, and they need to be able to snowball that correctly and do the objectives. Because otherwise, they're literally going to get fucking destroyed. Depends on the Sylvanas. If the Sylvanas falls behind, they're fucked. If the Izanami gets fucking soloed by the Scotty, they're fucked. If Sun Wukong doesn't at least do half decent in his lane, they're fucked. Like, if Hotbot doesn't pop off and get really good jungle pressure, they're fucked. So, like, there's so many things against the red team right now. So many things. It's actually insane. And not only that, like, Zeus has great early game. Humbats is Humbats. Like, he's just always pretty solid. Kabrakan has a great laning phase. Like, there's so many things that the blue team has going for them. I don't even know how they get a team comp like that. There's, I'm just, I have no fucking clue, dude. I'll be honest with you guys. Like, shit is wild. Blue team doesn't have sustain. Team Red has a lot of sustain. That doesn't fucking matter when you have crazy burst damage. Like, sustain's good and all. And sustain really does win games. Like, if you have a heal comp and the other team doesn't properly pick gods that deal with it or get actives that deal with it or whatever, then yeah, sustain is going to be a big deal. But there's so much burst damage, control, CC, and team fight potential out of the blue team. Like, sustain's not going to matter for shit. It really isn't. Like the red team really just has to destroy lanes. That's it. Hotbo's pick is very eh. I don't fucking know. It's just Zeus is going to be able to destroy anything. Any kind of opposition that sustains not going to really be a thing. And if the Sylvanas falls behind, then the red team's fucked. The Sylvanas has to be even or ahead at all points of the game, or else, like, he's literally going to die every single team fight. The second he pushes up out of tower, he's going to get CC'd and he's going to die to Zeus Humbats or any sort of combination. Gray Apples can ult with Shing Ten. God damn, dude. And then Izanami's laning phase is pretty good. Izanami has pretty good push and can 1v1, but not so much early. She really needs some items to get online. So if this Scotty plays it correctly, she should be able to at least get pressure. But it really depends on how they do the lanes. They could do a support mid and then have the jungler go solo lane and then control that side of the map. That's a very good strat. We saw that yesterday, actually, and it worked out really well. The team that Ivy thought was going to lose, even though they ended up losing, they destroyed early game. It's just the other team came back because they threw. That was the biggest thing. A big thing about Hotbo is he's really good at jungle. He's just really dumb, so he throws a lot of games. He's completely brainless. I don't know. We'll see what happens. I think this is going to be a good game, though. Like, I'm really excited for this fucking game. Okay, assisted. Let's see what happens here. All right, bros, because we got a lot of things going. Let's match up the gods. All right, Hunter with Hunter. Can this? Oh, okay, you gotta like click that. All right. Okay. So we have everything matched up. Let's take a look at the items and player cam. But yeah, it's Gray Apples, Fuddlemon Dung, Zek, Cloud and Vash versus Olivier. I can't say this name. Zavadi, Lima Beans, Hotbo, and Vanish. Which I don't even know who Vanish is. Yeah, I guess he's a sub because that's the only way you can get into these games. But yeah, and by the way, guys, if you're interested in joining sub games for prizes, make sure you subscribe. Sync up to the sub Discord. I typed the password in there. And yeah, it's going to be a fun old good time. Item wise, actually. This is interesting. We have the Ninja Tavi start, which I respect this start. I think this is fine. The only thing that's scary about this, he doesn't have sustain. So I'm not, Sylvanas is going to sustain her, but it really depends on how they play this lane. Meanwhile, for the Scotty, we have the Morningstar start. So both hunters are choosing not to get any kind of sustain. Personally, for me, I like going, Death's Toll boots, Bluestone boots, right? Because you get tons of pots, so you can play pretty risky and sustain in lane. Even with a Sylvanas, it's crazy. But both these hunters are going for the, being aggressive asshole start. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, looks like mid jungles are starting there. And in the solo lane, we have the Wukong versus Kabrakan matchup, which I'd imagine Kabrakan wins the laning phase, but Wukong has more tools to kind of clear the wave, and then he can solo Ellie's pretty easily. I don't know how he's gonna actually. Yeah, it doesn't look that didn't look too strong. He should be able to get out pushed here. Yeah, and he has the whole wave. So now Kabrakan, oh, he's going for the invade. Straight for the invade. I respect this call. Meanwhile, first blood. How did that happen? It looks like Zavadi actually just fucking sold that. Meanwhile, this fight speed buff. They invade that clean. Not much they can do. This is going to put Bastet severely behind. In the dual lane. Yeah, the Hunter being dead that early for first blood is actually wild. I can't even. That's going to put her so behind. But it looks like this team is getting fucking destroyed. Hotbo actually took the Wukong's wave, so that's going to put him even further behind. Because Kabrakan not only got two sides of buffs, but he's also going to get the wave. So jungle control right now is going to be in favor of the red team. They should be able to get a lot of buffs. Meanwhile, Scylla alone in the mid lane. I'm surprised they didn't go on her. Oh, okay, it's because Bastet's coming. They probably have a good idea. And I like this dual lane being very proactive. They're going to solo mid left Harpies, but they're going to lose a lane here. But Humbat's completely getting caught out. Not too sure what he was going for there. And that's two kills to the Izanami. Like I said, this bitch is a hyper carry. She can actually just solo carry a game if played correctly. She does crazy damage, has crazy attack speed. She has tons of tools in her arsenal to carry a game. So Izanami getting two kills early is fucking wild. It's actually insane. Meanwhile, Bastet being cheeky. No idea there's a faceless guy behind. And could easily get caught out. Yeah, Hotbo completely on the back foot here. He's completely fucked. He's Granted, the Humbats did die. He hasn't really been able to do anything so far in this early game. It's pretty fucking crazy. Nothing kind of crazy going on. Just simple laning phase. Really, the biggest focus here would be on Izanami, but it depends on how she's played this out. But she's level 5. Meanwhile, the junglers are level 3. So now she's going to be able to solo buffs, do her thing, and there's nothing you can really do about it. Which is crazy because this bitch only has Ninja Tabby. So any sort of poke, even with Sylvanas heal, could be very detrimental. But she seemed okay, and she's dealing with it well. I personally like Izanami with Death's Toll, but she's like, you know, fuck that altogether. We're just going to get full boots done. Which is also really good for the 1v1. A lot of people forget movement speed is great in this game because every single auto attack, ranged or melee, is a skill shot, right? So if you have high movement speed and you're able to juke or get away from said auto attacks because auto attacks in this game slow you, then yeah, it's like, what the fuck? Like, that's pretty crazy. Like, you can't really 1v1 someone that's faster than you if you can't hit your shots. So it's actually a pretty big deal that people forget. It's why Thanatos is so potent. It's because not only does he does crazy amount of damage and has to execute, but Thana can also run around at super high speeds. It's pretty crazy. Three-man grouping. It doesn't look like Hoppo was able to get the Elias there, but he is able to, there's a grouping for his buffs. Granted, the three-man sharing, it's still, like, he's so behind on experience, it hurts. Meanwhile, on the left side, red team being cheeky, they're just kind of, like, sniffing around. Where the fuck are they? Where's the buffs? Oracle's respawning soon. I want to see if the junglers actually contest for him. And personally, for me, Oracle's is very big. Like, I think Oracle's is extremely important. So we'll see how that goes. I like this. Everyone's backing up. Yeah, looks like that's about it. Nothing crazy kind of going on. Mid-left Harpy spawning, Oracle spawning. No one's going for it yet. I think Xing Tang knows. He's like, you know, we could get this, but he can't solo it. Hunter and mid-backed. So he's kind of by himself. Looks like he's soloing that, but he's not. There's no way he should be able to actually. Uh-oh, there's his jump. He could very easily die. Sylvanas ult. All the Scylla ult hits, but wow, he's really tanky. What does he have that he's able to survive? He only has Watcher's Gift boots. That's crazy. Meanwhile, invading the blue side, Hoppo getting Draco'd. Probably Humbat's ult. Missed that completely. Wukong forced the ult out. But that's another blue buff to the Kabrakan. Gonna get Kabrakan further and further ahead. Meanwhile, on the dual lane, Izanami being cheeky, knowing that she's winning the 1v1, stealing speed. I respect it. Yo, what's up, Hindu? He learned from the best F dot? Yeah, oh, dude. Forget about it. The stuff after the stuff. God bless. Nothing really kind of happening. Oracles, finally, I was wondering, I was like, you know, when are they going to notice that Oracles are up? But no one's really contesting. And personally for me, I think Oracles is such a big, like priority. Like, a lot of people don't prioritize Oracles as much, but I personally think Oracles is important. Golfier being started, big Izanami ult, three man, Xing Tang actually being the focus. There's an ult, Zeus ult down, able to protect for now. Sylvanas is the target now, it's completely immobile. Can't really get anything going, but they can't really follow up and kill him. Nothing too crazy going out. Hoppo being taken out by Humbats. Meanwhile, Scotty ult is there. Whoa, the 1v1 kind of goes down. Fuddlemundung able to take out Izanami, but Zek is here, able to clean up. Red team barely kind of win that fight, but the Zek rotation was clean. I respect it. Zek is very aware, and once he gets a lead, his rotations are usually spot on, so it's nice to see him kind of be a part of the fight, where most solo laners kind of just focus on their lane. Zek is always there for the team fight. God bless. Nothing else kind of going. Everyone's going to move back to a laning phase. Meanwhile, looking at builds, Scotty going for the classic Transcendence. Reinforced Greaves for Grey Apples to be extra tanky, which I think personally the build for supports would be Watcher's Gift, Reinforced Greaves, Mark of the Vanguard. You are literally invincible for all of early to mid game. So maybe he's going that route. Meanwhile, for the blue team, Travelers for the Sylvanas, which I respect, you know, able to get that extra gold. Sylvanas base tank stats are actually extremely high for no fucking reason. You know, for a tree, it's kind of insane, so. Hoppo going classic Bastet, Bluestone Boots. I want to see if he goes for like a split push Bastet or a team fight Bastet. Personally, I think split pushing is red, is blue team's kind of claim to fame here. Team fight wise, I think red team wins every single time. The gank onto Scotty. Scotty completely unaware. Cat should be able to slow. Izanami ult. I love it. Hoppo credited with the kill. Yeah, Funnelman Dung very unaware there. 1-3. I mean, granted, he did get a kill and he's going to be fine. But having being three levels behind enemy hunter and getting ganked just means you're not being aware enough, really. And it's crazy because he does have a ward there, so he should have been able to see it kind of coming. But I guess Funnelman Dung focused too much on the Izanami there. Gulfier being started up. Zek is there though. There's the teleport. Literally with that teleport, Zek forced them out. Maybe a team fight going down. Sylvanas being the target. I respect it. Stun out. Stun. Kabrakan wall. No way Sylvanas can get out. The Sylvanas ult to try to self peel himself, but no, he's done. Especially with Zeus there. That's it. Olivier down. Red team. Making sure that nothing else kind of happens. And this is what I mean. The team fight is just so potent, so strong out of the red team. I can't. There's no way for the blue team to kind of contest that. Now, what seemed like such a big win for the blue team, red team take full advantage of killing the support, and they're just going to do Gold Fury, but Hoppo trying to answer back. He might be actually be able to steal it. Zeus has great confirm, so I don't know if that's the smart choice, but Scylla ult could definitely steal it. Oh my goodness, but Red Team get it at the last second. That is wild. Vanish suicides, which I respect it because that looked really close. I really thought he was going to steal it there, but not exactly the case. But I definitely respect it. Hoppo might actually be able to pick up some kills. Cats are out. I don't know. These cats. Yeah, there's one cat, two cats on the Zeus. Not able to actually survive. Humbats barely survives with his life. Meanwhile, Funnelman Dung getting caught out again by the dual lane. Working together. I'm not too sure. This is what I mean. So our Sylvanas, because he's getting focused, is so far behind. Just hitting level 7. No bueno. No bueno. Sylvanas behind is probably like the worst. It's like being behind on your mirror. You're in a mobile guardian, severely behind on gold and experience, and you just get focused every fight, but you're forced to initiate, so you just die. It's not fun. Not fun at all. So let's see if he's able to at least somewhat keep up, because Sylvanas behind, like I said, is just not the vision. Press L to get rid of that slow. Done, dude. Thank you. I appreciate it, Hindu. I'm not a cameraman. I'm not a caster. Don't at me. Like I said, by the way, so these sub games are for prizes, skin codes, and gems. So it's going to go out to one person, the MVP of the winning team. So I'm going to make sure chat votes for it. Meanwhile, oh my god, behind Tom Clancy. No, Hoppo not able to actually escape there. I was wondering if they're going to go for it. Red team has tons of pressure. You see them roaming the map all inside blue team's territory. So crazy stuff happening. Gank coming out. Looks like the target here is Izanami. Not actually. Oh, completely whiffing the ult. And Keesh the God is down. Meanwhile, Scotty being cats, he's slowed. But red team there to answer back. Hoppo doesn't have a jump, but is able to still escape thanks to speed buff. Yeah, no, that Humbats play, that was just pure mechanics fail. Like, that was just ugly as fuck. Izanami had a little bit of fun laughing that shit away, God bless. Yeah, that whiffed ult really just kind of, like, right on that, he should have just backed up, but jumping into the Izanami sealed his fate on top of getting hit by the Izanami ult. Meanwhile, we actually have an invade. I respect it. Oh, 1v1 going down. Funnelman Dung just not able to keep up with the fed Izanami. And now that's going to be tier 1 tower. So much pressure in the dual lane. It's actually insane. But Hoppo able to get a little bit of something invading the Humbat speed. And now the red team, they're actually falling a little bit behind, being like 2k gold down. That's no bueno. But maybe during the team fights, they'll be able to take it around. But so far for the early laning phase, blue team able to keep up and keep a very small lead. 12 minutes in the game looking at the builds. We actually have interesting build here. Kabrakking. Oh, Border Demon being started. Red team should be able to get this. I mean, it's only Sylvanas. If Sylvanas steals, like, I've seen it all. Really. Kabrakking all. I respect it. Did Sylvanas steal that? It's blue. Bro, Sylvanas stole it. Are you kidding me? Oh, what the fuck was that? Oh, holy moly. Sylvanas being the focus here for the team fight. Like I said, too much pressure. But Zeus not being peeled correctly. Sanctuary not enough. Hobo credited with the kill. Red team still in this team fight. Wukong slapping down people. Kabrakking a little bit injured. But, yeah, Sylvanas stole that shit. I can't even... That's wild, really. Humbat's really overstaying. He definitely overstayed there, getting cleaned up by Hotbell. Not good, not good. Kabrakan being the target here. Gray Apple's trying to peel. I respect it, but Scotty ult. Not even being targeted on anyone. Scott, the dog was not doing it. Lyman Beans credit with the kill on Gray Apples. And blue team just really outplaying the red team right now. Like, they have tons of pressure experience-wise they're behind. And now... getting a tier 1 tower in the mid lane. Blue team are able to, yeah, MVP definitely going to Sylvanas there. Stealing the portal demon was just huge play. And then the blue team were able to turn around the team fight somehow due to red team's misplay. The biggest thing, I want to see Hunbats be a little bit more involved with, like, better ults, right? Like, I want to see Hunbats ulting, Zeus ult. But red team just seemed very not coordinated, and free Gold Fury going to the blue team. Very easy. No pressure on the map right now. Tier 1 tower and mid down. A lot of people forget that map control wise, the tier 1s are so important. With tier 1 being down, Zeus is going to have to play extremely, extremely conservative because he's going to have no way of actually dealing with pressure. Like, really, he's gonna have to self-peel himself with proper positioning. And that was the biggest thing for that fight. Zeus get caught up by Hotbow, and that's, like, one of Bastet's strengths, right? Is, you know, go in the back line, catch the immobile targets, and, you know, slow them down, kill them. And Hotbow was able to do that. Hotbow in enemy territory, but speed buff, able to get him out of any kind of danger. Kabrakan was kind of... he was reaching, but not able to actually get anything going. Red team, they do have pretty decent vision. Meanwhile, on the left side of the map, crazy war control. 6 level advantage for the Izanami versus Scotty. I've never seen that. That's actually, like, you have to really try to fall that behind because, yeah, being level 10 while the Izanami is level 16, I've really seen it all. Like, I don't even know if he would be able to defend a tier 2. But you know what's good about Zavadi's Izanami? He's very aware of where the team fight is happening. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, target being Sylvanas again. I'm not too sure focusing the Sylvanas is the vision anymore, really. If I was the red team, I'd be more of... I agree with the pressure. Oh, is it not? Oh, Izanami ult misses, but Kish the God getting cleaned up by Hotbow. And really, because Kish the God is not able to position correctly, there's no way for red team to actually get a proper team fight. I mean, like, this, the Humbat seems practically useless at this point. He's not able to do anything, but great Kabrakan all capturing the Scylla. Even with Sanctuary, he has no escape, and Scylla is down, getting literally slapped to death, vanish. A little bit out of position. He was kind of by himself there. I think he was just unaware of where his team was doing, which is common when you don't have comms like this. You know, you get a little confused sometimes, maybe overstay your welcome. Nothing crazy kind of happening. I'm surprised we don't see Izanami going more for the split push while the 4v4 is kind of going down. But I think with this level lead, he's not too worried about that. He's just focused on the big team fight. Gray Apples initiating, forcing Izanami dash. Nothing really happening. I don't think a red team wants to venture that far into enemy territory. Like I said, 2 immobile carries being that far pushed up, you really have to commit to a big fight. And map control wise, red team just don't have it. Map control goes completely to the blue team, having all their tier 1s up and great vision there's no way for them to really kind of push up and be safe. You know, there's no fallback. Oracles. It looks like it went to the blue team there. I'm not too sure. Shing Ten initiating Gray ult, forcing Beads and Sylvanas ult. I respect that. Gray Apples, Mio on the back line. Wukong looking for the slapdown. This is what I mean. Zeus not able to actually do anything, but Wukong can't actually stay on the target. He actually missed his abilities. Mechanics-wise, we're seeing a lot of missed abilities, missed auto attacks. But that's because my subs suck dick, really. Izanami started Bluestone. Izanami started Ninja Tabby, actually. Just straight Ninja Tabby. No starter items. Blue team being so pretty far ahead. The biggest thing here is like they would have to throw. But like I said, team fight wise, the red team should be able to contest. But it depends. Like, this Izanami is so far ahead at this point. She could solo carry the game depending on how she builds, which she's doing the proper build. I respect the crit with the Titan's Bane. Gonna be doing a ton of damage. So let's see how the Izanami plays it out. Looking at relics, the Wukong actually went horrific emblem. Slows movement speed. I think that's actually the play, because if Wukong's able to initiate into a team fight, being able to slow the Scotty or Zeus could force Beads. So I kind of respect this. Meanwhile, 1v1 going down. Fuddleman Dunn kind of overstaying his welcome. You can see he was pushed up a little bit too far. When you're pushed up that far and you're literally six levels down, what are you doing? Meanwhile, big team fight. Red team able to actually get the Portal Demon this time. Sylvanas ult. Big peel. Red team get credited with another kill. Humbat's ult completely. I mean, not Humbat's ult, but Humbat's completely out of position. Wukong ult forced. And red team actually, like I said, they want another team fight. As long as they can rinse and repeat that and maybe minimize the Humbat's deaths, red team should be able to actually come back into this game if they can focus objectives a little bit more. But meanwhile, in the dual lane, tier 2 tower getting decimated by the Fed Izanami. God, golly, Zavadi! I'm not too sure to actually say his name, but I'll call him Big Z. Big Z! Really controlling enemy buffs, 1v1ing the enemy hunter, and indirectly pressuring a lane, forcing the red team to kind of respond. And like I said, with the Scotty being so far behind, she has no hope of 1v1ing. So when you have that much pressure in a lane, it's actually insane. Blue team credit with stealing the Gold Fury. Nothing actually happening. The red team very unaware. Now being up so much gold, like 8,000 gold, 9,000 gold in the lead. Crazy. Big thing here is red team need a little bit more objective pressure. I would like to see them pressure maybe a tier 1 in the soul lane. I think that's one of their best bets. Or maybe just camp to Izanami, but she's level 19 at this point. She'd be able to 1v2, 1v3. Especially with the Humbats. The Humbats mechanics have been very off. I mean, he's not doing too bad. 4, 5, and 5. It's okay, but I don't know. His mechanics aren't the vision right now. Grouping over here, I would like to see the Izanami kind of position around Fire Giant. At this point, she can essentially solo FG, especially with Devo gloves fully stacked. Izanami can completely destroy. Meanwhile, big dive on Vash, Hoppo getting him below half, forcing him to back. And this the vision right now, if I were the blue team, all right guys, let's do FG. Zeus is forced back. We don't know where their jungler is. He's just kind of doing his own thing. Let's pressure Fire Giant, which the blue team might actually do now, especially with Izanami getting that much closer to full build, being level 20 at 21 minutes. That is insane. You really have to farm your brains out to be level 20 this early in the game. I mean, look at the Sylvanas being level 12. Like, you're just not even close. So, big thing here. We'll see if they pressure. Probably red buff to Fire Giant would be my call, but we'll see what the blue team kind of does here. One of the only tier 1s left is Kabrakins. I would like to see him. Maybe a good play here for the blue team would be pressure tier 1 solo into Fire Giant, but big fight kind of going out. Zeus ult whiffing completely. That was more of a defensive self-pierce assault. And, red team kind of back up. Nothing really happening. No objective pressure coming out of both teams. It's just kind of like still like a jungle laning phase, which is really weird this late in the game. Wukong being a little bit pushed up. This would have been a great gank potential, but yeah, Kabrakan really slapping him around. Small grouping over here. No portal demon up, but maybe Izanami. They could definitely start the fire giant at this point, or at least bait it out for a big team fight. Meanwhile, Habbo completely. Whoa. And this is what I mean about Habbo. Like, he's pretty good at the game. He's just fucking stupid. There was no reason for him to actually be up there. So Habbo completely out of position. For like because of that play indirectly, Fire Giant can't be started by the blue team anymore, and now they have to wait even longer, which is good because with more time means that the red team have more chances to catch up and maybe even win the game, come back. Like I said, with their team fight, there's no reason they can't win a team fight. They should actually be able to still win every single team fight if played correctly. Vash is going to have to stay alive, but he's going to have a hard time. But with Habbo dead, I agree with this play. Let's pressure the tier 1. Let's get something going. Vash being the big target here. It's getting completely slapped down, but Humbat's ult for the self-peel. Sylvanas ult. Only hitting the Humbat's. It's not me ult whiffing completely. In the backline, Grey Apples is the big target. Scylla ult down, and red team now are in a 4v4. Yo, we got a subscriber. Yo, Azure, thanks for the 6 months. Welcome back to the church. I do appreciate it. Pressure on the soul lane. Last tier one for the red team going down, and red team forced to retreat away. Biggest thing there was no really big focus on anything, and nothing really happens. So now Fire Giant, Portal Demon being started by the Izanami. With her being literally close to full build, free Portal Demon. She actually decided to go Poison Star. I wonder if this would be the final build or she's going to go for Deathbringer. Really bad tanking coming out of the Izanami, getting hit with the pillar. And because of that bad tanking, she actually is forced to back. She got really kind of messed up there. Not too sure where the mid harpies went to. It looks like it went to the blue team. Habbo may be able to secure that, but I don't know, man. Biggest thing here is blue team aren't taking, in my opinion, full advantage of their experience and gold lead. I mean, they're up at this point 10k gold. They should be pressuring maybe Fire Giant more, forcing more fights, looking for picks would be the play, but it's still like a semi laning phase. But that's because my subs are just really fucking bad. Habbo still successfully invading red and blue. I respect that. Blue team getting the gold fury. Objective wise for Portal Demon and gold, blue team are getting that every single time. But with this lead, they should definitely be pressuring. Maybe even tier 2s at this point. We'll see. Red team with a small grouping on the right side of the map. We'll see if they can actually get vision. Blue team having really great vision in the enemy backline. They're able to see any kind of pathing that the red team might do to stop them. So they're being very aware. Like I said, these back wards are so important because you get to see where the enemy paths to, where they're going, and the red team actually starting Fire Giant. I don't know if this is the vision right now. They don't have an ADC here. They don't have the DPS, no reason to take free damage. And I think realizing that, red team backs up. Nothing really happening, still kind of like a farming phase, which I don't really agree with. I think at this point the blue team should definitely be up in their phase, a little bit more pressure, maybe a little bit more pick potential. I think you should accept that your subs are average gold 3. You know, my subs are fucking terrible. I'm not gonna lie. My subs are fucking garbage, but I love them to goddamn death. They're my monkeys, bro. But they will get better over time. I know for a fact, I've had a lot of subs that like have been completely garbage, and they play, and they have gotten better, so I respect. Small grouping here by the red team. I'm not too sure. Everyone's kind of like pussyfooting. Like, they're not really, there's no full commitments here. Everyone's like, I think I'll go in. No, I don't know. What the fuck? Humbat's completely He's dead. I mean, if Wukong can actually... Oh, all right, you gotta hit your autos, bro. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, Zavani completely taken out on Gray Apple, maybe overstaying his welcome. Wukong whiffing the kill attempt onto Humbats. And this is what I mean. The biggest thing with the Humbats, he just kind of walks into traffic, right? He's like, all right, enemy team there. Car coming my way. I could die here. I'm just going to kind of walk into it. Like, he's very, very unaware of positioning, and it's costing his team a lot. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, pressure onto tier 2, which I respect. This is what they should be doing. Grabbing all the towers, pressuring Fire Giant, and maybe the blue team now. This is so much map control. Take enemy buffs, pressure Fire Giant. Izanami's literally full built. Deathbringer coming out. We have the triple crit. There's no reason they should not be destroying this Fire Giant. Please hit the Fire Giant. It's right here. Please? All right, yeah, there we go. I thought they were just going to walk by. This is what they need to be doing. Bait it out. Force the Fire Giant. Kabrak. Oh, the blink. And I think a little bit too early. And they force it. Why didn't they take that fight? That's the biggest question. I guess because Wukong's at half. I'm not too sure. But Kabrak and blinked out. Meanwhile, what the fuck is Hot Buds? This is what I mean. No brain. I don't know what the fuck he's doing over here. He should be at Fire Giant, but whatever. Stealing the red buff here is actually very good. Very good. Very, very good. I don't know why he's not taking purple. Come on, Hoppo. What the fuck? Just take the buff. Like, whatever. Looks like he's backing. So, blue team, even though, like, I mean, red team, even though they are severely behind, experience-wise, you see, like, as this game goes on, they're catching up little by little by little. We have three level 20s on the side of blue team, but they are trying to get there. Red team actually starting the Fire Giants at half health. Anyone could get at this point. It looks like, I don't know what Humbat's doing. He's tanking the Fire Giant. He actually dies to the Fire Pool. Where is it going to go? Blue team steal the Fire Giant, and with a very bad attempt... yeah, they're not able to actually do anything. Devani taking out Funnelman Dung, and now blue team, they are chasing. Whoa, crazy damage coming out, and Vash goes down, not able to actually get away. Maybe too much of a lazy back, and red team completely wipe with that failed Fire Giant attempt. That was just a bad call, really, for the team. It was just no bueno. There's the surrender vote. We get to see who was MVP. I'm going to start a poll right now. That game kind of fucking sucked. Who was MVP? Dun, dun, dun. I want you guys to vote. Oh shit. Sylvanas. That was a pretty It was decent. It was a decent games. It was decent. You know what I'm saying? Like I felt like it could have been so much more. I'm creating the poll right now. Make sure you guys vote. You guys have their